Hi friends, I am Aisha. How are you? Today we are going to know about digital world. What's better, a computer or a brain? Computers can rattle through billions of sums every second and tell you the name of every king and queen that has ever lived. But the fastest supercomputer on the planet is less powerful than a mouse's brain and takes up a million times more space. Computers are electronic machines we can use to do many different things just by changing the instruction stored inside them. The first computers were little more than giant calculators. Later, people found that computers had superb memories. They could store many information much more reliably than the human brain. Many people now use their computers as communication tools to make friends, send emails, and share the things they like. This is possible because virtually all of the world's computers are connected together in a giant worldwide network called the Internet. Part computer and part human brain. The online world of the Internet brings us the best of both. How a computer works? Computers are electronic machines that take in information, record it, work on it in various ways, and then show the results of what they have done. These four stages are called input, storage, processing, and output, and they are carried out by separate pieces of equipment. You can input information using a keyboard, mouse, touchscreen, or microphone. The information is usually stored in either a hard drive or memory chips. Processing is done by the main processor chips. The results are output on a screen or spoken through loudspeakers. Keyboard. Most computers get their input from a typewriter keyboard, but tablets have keyboards that pop up on screen. Mouse. A mouse is moved to control a pointer on the screen. Mouse can be cable linked or wireless. Processor chip. Processor chip, also known as a microprocessor. This is a complex integrated circuit that carries out all of the computer's main operations. The more powerful the microprocessor, the faster it can work through problems. Memory chips. Modern computers often use flash memory chips instead of magnetic hard drives because they are more reliable and use less power. Screen. Ordinary computers use color LCD screens to display their output. On a tablet computer, the touch screen serves as both the input and the output. Types of computer. A desktop computer has four separate units for the keyboard, mouse, processor, and screen. Laptops have all of these things built into a single portable unit. Tablet computers squeeze the same parts into even less space by building the keyboard and mouse into the screen. Yearly computers. Computers are based on calculators that simply add numbers. The first mechanical calculators appeared in the 7th century. When people found ways to make calculators automatic, computers were born. The first electronic computer that could be programmed to do different jobs was ENIAC computer. completed in 1946. It was bigger than a lorry and had more than 100,000 separate parts. Supercomputers. Some scientific problems are so huge and complex that an ordinary home computer might take years to solve them. For intricate problems such as weather forecasting, we need more powerful computers that work a different way. Some of them have tens of thousands of processors all working on a problem at once. How supercomputers work? Most giant supercomputers use a system called parallel processing, where problems are broken up into small bits and tackled by separate processes, although it takes time to break up and reassemble problems. Overall, it's much faster to work this way. NASA supercomputer. The American Space Agency NASA runs this powerful supercomputer called Pleiades. It has 112,896 individual processors arranged inside 185 separate workstations. How the internet works? The internet is a worldwide network that links together virtually every computer on the planet, well over a billion of them. Each computer has its own address so that any other machine on the network can instantly send emails or messages to it or receive them from it. Packet switching. When you email a photo, it does not travel over the internet in one big lump. Instead, it's broken into tiny packets. Each one is given the final IP address and travels separately. This makes data stream across the internet very efficiently. Getting online. Well over half the world's population is now online. People in richer countries such as the USA were first to get connected in the mid-1990s. But even people in some of the poorest developing countries are now online. Having access to up-to-date information is expected to make it easier for people in poorer countries to gain a decent education. Social networks. Many people use their computers for chatting to friends and sharing photos or news. Popular websites such as Facebook and Twitter have hundreds of millions of regular users. If you like my video, like this channel, share to others and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.